va koijaye, iva koijaye, iva koijaye. Television.
We all know you are very many producers, but I'm not just some of the television.
Yes, I know.
I know you very much, and I've known you for a long time. We can see that there is a very beautiful program going on here. First and foremost, we want to have you as well, some of them, let me know you. Can you please introduce yourself? What are we doing today? And what is the essence, the significance of the program today?
Thank you very much. Good afternoon, everyone. My name is the Honorable Fatima Aduke Mohammed. I am the People's Democratic candidate for the Federal House of Representatives, Ifakoijaiye, Federal Constituency. I'm sure that many of you have reason to come across me at sometimes in your sojourn in Ifakoijaiye. Today is a very wonderful day for us. This is the second phase of our women empowerment. This time around, we try to diversify a bit. We're doing women and youth. For us, we believe that once you empower a woman, you help her to speak above a whisper, you help her to be productive in her marriage, and like I say all the time, a wife of no impact is a wife of no value. So for me, it's empowering the women, making them valuable in their husband's homes, making them valuable in the lives of their children. I decided to put the youth this time. This is the second phase, like I said. We had 450 people in the first phase. We decided to bring in youth this time because we realized that Ifakoijaiye, being the second largest local government with over 675,000 people residents here, we decided to make our youth a bit more productive. We find out that you have a lot of junctions. You know what you popularly know as junction or Malta and all of that, you know. I say all the time, I say, because I'm going to but the circumstances of the country has restricted our growth, you know, as youth. So this time around, I've said to the youth, come and get productive, come and learn a trade. We will not only teach you a trade, we'll give you seedlings of a trade that we've taught you. We'll go furthermore to, we're working with the prolific merchant microfinance bank. So the prolific microfinance bank will give you a soft loan. We will pay the interest. You will take your loan. The loan would be between, it has to be what you can pay. It's between 50,000 and 500,000. But you must justify what you want to use the money for. Because the loan is usually for startup grants for you to take off whatever you're doing. So that's basically what we're doing today, the second phase. We're going to have the next phase the last week in the month of November, the first of the month of September. This time we're doing 700 women and youth. Yeah, we keep getting better by the day.
And for how long? What's the duration of
it's usually a week.
A week, so month. Yes. Today is Monday now.
Today is Monday.
So you Monday through Friday.
Through Friday.
Now, ma'am, you say you are the widow, you are the candidate of the
People's Democratic Party
for Ifakoijaiye, the Federal Constituency in the House of Representatives. And you know you have some challenges in the other parties, especially APC.
Yes.
How do you see your chances?
Well, when you say that I have challenges in APC, it makes me laugh. You know why I'm laughing?
What?
The present person who is meant to be challenging me, by God's grace, I made him the House of Representatives. Yeah. And I've said this severally. When he was going to contest, when he was going to contest, they came to make me the hierarchy of the party, and they said, at that time I was aggrieved, I was actually supposed to contest with him. And so they said, oh, they needed my assistance. And I asked him a straight question. I said, you and I on the field, do you think you can beat me? He said, no. And I said, not to worry, I will ensure that you win. So I gave him conditions that day. I said, the first condition is that you must be House of Rep member to the APC, the PDP, the Labour Party, whatever party alike. You must, first and foremost, your allegiance is to the people of Ifakoijaiye. Forget your political party. Your political party is not come second, but the first place to the indigents of Ifakoijaiye. But he did not do that. He did not keep to that promise. I felt so bitter that, like I said, Ifakoijaiye is the second largest. I take a look around the local government, and like I say all the time, poverty walks on the streets. And I'm wondering that you have a House of Rep member who has a constituency allowance every quarter. And the only thing he has used this money for is to pay his godfathers. And that's why you can see that when they did their APC primaries, he came last. But because he has been using money to sell to his godfathers, they brought him back. And like I always call him, customer dad. So, fine. Okay. I said to them, I don't know what candidates they want to present to me. I said, no matter who it is. So for some of them, it might be a tight rope, but I'm still win by his grace. But bringing customer dad to me, we're going to just be sleeping and relaxing. But we're not resting on our arms. We're going to keep working because we're sure that the victory in 2019 is going to be by the level of work that we have done. And to God be the glory, I've been able to imprint myself in the heart of the electorate in Ifakoijaiye, federal constituency, and Ojokoro as well. You know, so 2019 is going to be beyond party lines. It's not going to be PDP or APC. It's going to be the personality. And so I am Jerry Nakiumi because this is Ifakoijaiye Television. And APC Lenny Station, I dare you to present your candidate. Let him campaign based on his antecedents. What has he done? Okay. He's going to be campaign based on issues.
Okay, let me first correct one impression.
Yes.
Ifakoijaiye Television is not owned by APC.
Even if it is owned by APC, we are all in Ifakoijaiye. We will
that.
Force them and make sure we all own it.
I'm just correcting
it's
that.
It's our TV.
And it's not even owned by the local government. A separate entity on its own. And we
even
all
if it is owned by the local government,
then you will still
this local government belongs to us,
all of us.
And nobody is going to cheat us out of our property.
Amen.
So whatever they are doing in APC, we will fight and enter. They set up our okay, as a program in the state. All of us are going there.
We
are wearing less talk if I, oh yes, nobody
because
can
tell
us. We are Ifakoijaiye, so we must go.
Now, yes. I have a follow-up question to what you said. You said that when Akunle wanted to contest,
yes, he came to meet me.
He came to meet
not only him.
Now with the
Sakafa Funmi was there. We had Jide Jimo. He was a whole lot of Tobauke was there.
Was
well.
There too. Okay. Then you can you assure our viewers, the people of Ifakoijaiye, federal constituency, that if and when you go there, that you will also be a representative not of only PDP, but of APC, of Labour Party, and so on.
Let me rephrase your question. You say if, it's no longer a case. When I get there, when I become the House of Representatives, come the 16th of February 2019, they would give me the certificate of return, and I would be representing the entire members, the entire people of Ifakoijaiye Federal Constituency.
Notwithstanding their
no PDP, no APC, no Muslim, no Christian. We're one body in this place, and I will stand and speak above a whisper and turn this local government around. Like I say all the time, a new Ifakoijaiye is possible. This is a bold step, and I'm going to take it with every one of us together. Thank you very much.
Okay, thank you very much, man. I wish you all the best.
Thank you, sir.
Okay, thank you.
Television, Mangbala Shanta, I will kill you. Oluwa lo firan wa ade ori oke osite ekeye oruko mi ni Damlola Mustafa Ifakoijaiye Television e ma wo la
Ifakoijaiye Television Ifakoijaiye Television Gbangba la shanta awo kilumo Oluwa lo firan wa ade oke ojo teye keye.